maintenance of wife under section 24 and 25 of Hindu Marriage Act 1958, maintenance of wife under section 18 clause 2 and 18 clause 1 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act 1956, and maintenance of wife, children and parents under section 125 CRPC is the topic for discussion today, dear friends. A Hindu wife can claim maintenance from husband under section 24 and 25 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955. So section 24 refers to temporary relief or interim relief or pendant delight. Section 25 relates to permanent relief or permanent maintenance. Section 18 clause 2 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act refers to maintenance of Hindu wife against husband who is separated on reasonable ground. Section 18 clause 1 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act 1956 relates to maintenance of wife against husband who is living in the same roof. Even by living in same roof, why Hindu wife can claim maintenance against husband under section 18 clause 1. Even though a Hindu wife can claim maintenance under Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act and Hindu Marriage Act, there is a provision for maintenance of children education, unmarried children, unmarried daughters marriage and other basic and genuine needs. These genuine basic needs also of children and other dependents, if any, will be taken into consideration. But a Hindu wife can claim maintenance against husband under section 24 for temporary relief, 25 for permanent relief of Hindu Marriage Act 1955. Under Hindu Marriage Act, husband also can claim maintenance under the wife, against the wife, if he is unable to live on his own, if he is physically and mentally unfit to make his earnings, that is there. So, Hindu Marriage Act 1955, section 24 and 25 make provision for maintenance of not only wife but also husband. Section 24 is for temporary or interim relief or pendant delight. Section 25 is for permanent relief. Section 18 clause 2 and 18 clause 1 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act make provision for a Hindu wife to claim maintenance against the husband. Under section 18.2, a Hindu wife who got separated from husband on reasonable grounds can claim maintenance even though she is able to live on her own, she is making earnings for livelihood, she is having properties. Such woman can claim. And under section 18 clause 2 refers to a Hindu married woman who is living separately from husband on reasonable grounds. Section 18 clause 1 relates to Hindu married woman who can claim maintenance against husband living in the same roof, with the husband. So this, these two acts, Hindu Marriage Act and Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act, are independent. A Hindu woman, married woman, if required, can file petition on both the acts, Hindu Marriage Act and Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act. In addition to that, there is one more special provision which provides speedy relief, that is section 125 CRPC, which makes provision for maintenance of wife, children and aged parents. Under 125 CRPC, petition can be filed in first class magistrate court for maintenance. Wife can file petition independently, children can file petition independently, parents also can file petition independently. Under CRPC, not only Hindus, Christians, Muslims and all communities are entitled to claim maintenance by filing a petition under section 125 CRPC in a first class magistrate court. But in Hindu law, a married woman can claim, can file petition for maintenance either in district court or in family law, family law court for maintenance. So Hindu 24-25 Hindu Marriage Act, 18-1-18-2 adoption, Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act, 125 CRPC, all the three provisions are independently independent. One can file petition under all the three grounds. All the three grounds, and one can file petition on two grounds, either one or two or three. However, if benefit is received, maintenance is received by wife or any other claimant, the court will take into consideration while fixing the maintenance, the court will look into matter whether the petitioner is receiving maintenance from other provision. Suppose while trying 125 while trying petition under 18 CRPC, 18-1 CRPC, 18-2 CRPC, 24 or 25 CRPC, the court will examine whether the petitioner has already received maintenance under 125 CRPC or other. So depending on that, the court may dismiss the petition or reduce the petition. So this is the reason why one ground is not a bar for other ground. The petitioner can claim maintenance under all the three grounds or two grounds or one ground. Because of the reason that petition is filed on all the three grounds, the person, the claimant will not get three maintenance in three hands. So this is the position. Dear friend, today I wish to take up this maintenance of wife under Hindu Marriage Act and Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act and common provision 125 CRPC, wife, children and parents is the topic for today. Before taking up this topic, dear friend, let me take an opportunity, just 1 minute, to pray God. Pay homage to my reverend parents Rega Apparao and late Srimati Kanta Ratnam and my beloved wife Mrs. Baliwada T. Gauri, associate author of all my academic works. Academic works. Let me express my deep sense of gratitude to all my Godfather, in particular to my student friends, that is viewers, subscribers and all. And finally, it is my duty to express my heartfelt thanks and gratitude to authors and publishers of authors of textbooks and research papers and articles in internet, whose works I am making use for delivering this lecture. And dear friends, so as you are aware that I am principal, retired, Pridashni Jan Prabodhini Aided Law College, Maharashtra, India. I am the author of more than 35 law textbooks and many books, guides, question and answers. My books are in good circulation. 25 textbooks have been translated into Hindi. I also gave consent for translation of all my textbooks into 4 or 5 South Indian languages and 2 North Indian languages, Marathi and Gujarati. The publishers may take their own time to translate them, but however, one day or other, they also will be released. Some students are asking me where my books are available. If you check in Google, you can have my books all over India online. All leading publishers in India are dealing with my books. So don't think that I am giving publicity of my books, because I am no way concerned with any royalty of these books. For your information only I am telling. Some students asked me even in the comments also. Dear friends, so today I wish to take up the most important topic for discussion is maintenance. This is very important topic, not only from examination point of view, but also general knowledge and common sense point of view. First of all, I want to take up section 24 and 25 Hindu Marriage Act 1955. A Hindu woman can claim maintenance from husband under section 24 and 25 of the Hindu Marriage Act. Similarly, husband also can claim maintenance from wife under this provision. Under Hindu Marriage Act 24-25 only, husband can claim maintenance from the wife. But the condition, there are some conditions are this. So here, if wife wants to file a petition or husband wants to file a petition, they should file a petition in appropriate court, that is the district court or family law court. That is one thing. Secondly, both wife and husband must be Hindus and legally wedded couple. Next condition is the petitioner is unable to live on his or her own. The petitioner is unable to live on his or her own. A woman, though physically and mentally all right, if she is unable to live on her own, she can file a petition under against husband for maintenance. Suppose husband wants to file a petition against wife, he is unable to live on her own, first condition. Second condition, he is physically or mentally unfit, he is unable to make his own earnings. But the court will ask him, if you are physically, mentally okay, you can do any work, even labor job, and you live on your own. But if woman is physically and mentally strong, court will not ask a woman to do servant maid job and live on your own. So this is the condition. So husband can file a petition, wife can file a petition against the other spouse, but petitioner is unable to live on own. Both must be Hindus. The marriage is legally wedded marriage. If husband wants to file a petition, he should not be if he is physically mentally fit to make earning, he cannot file. If he is physically mentally unfit, he can file. Suppose your husband is physically mentally fit, filed a petition, the petition was dismissed in a case Kanchan versus Kamlendra, Bombay High Court dismissed the petition. This gentleman, petitioner husband, closed business due to losses, but he was physically and mentally okay. He filed petition against wife for maintenance. Because of the reason he closed business, he doesn't have earnings. The court did not like to give, but since he was physically and mentally all right, court did not grant any maintenance. The petition of husband against wife was dismissed. Secondly, one, legally wedded. Secondly, unable to live on own. Third one, the petitioner should not living separately on reasonable grounds. Living separately on a reasonable ground. There are several grounds under Section 10 and Section 30 and Hindu Marriage Act. Section 10 because of desertion or cruelty, desertion, cruelty, cruelty, unchastity, conversion. So many grounds are there, infectious disease, living in adultery, so many conditions are there. In divorce, I will explain in detail. So like this. So the husband, the wife is living separately from husband on reasonable grounds. Any ground which the court finds it as reasonable, that ground is enough. So after living separately, the wife should not get remarried. She should not get remarried. She should not be unchaste. She must not be living in adultery. Next, suppose the wife living separately under divorce by mutual consent. Divorce by mutual consent under Section 13B of Hindu Marriage Act. Such wife cannot claim maintenance. If she gets converted into other religion. So the basic condition is both husband and wife must be Hindus. If wife can get professes Islam, converts into Islam or Christian or any other community, non-Hindu community, she is not entitled to claim maintenance. So these are the various grounds for maintenance. These are the various grounds for maintenance. Next is kinds of relief. So the relief under Hindu Marriage Act is two categories. One is temporary relief or pendant delight or interim relief. Second one is permanent relief. Under Shashi, a Hindu wife can file a petition against husband who is unable to live on her own under section 24 for temporary relief, because we know the process of giving judgment, adjudication and judgment will take long time, many years it may take. Till the final judgment comes, the petitioner cannot stop. So for immediate relief can be claimed invoking section 24 of the Hindu Marriage Act. Similarly, if the husband is physically and mentally unfit to do any work and make any earning, that husband also can file a petition against the wife for interim relief or temporary relief or pendant delight. So for a time, because there are certain cases, some case may be pending before some appropriate court for restitution of conjugal rights under section 9 of Hindu Marriage Act, or judicial separation case is pending under section 10 of Hindu Marriage Act, petition for divorce is pending between the parties under section 13 Hindu Marriage Act. If the petition for is pending under section 13B, it is not admitted because mutual separated couple are not entitled to claim any maintenance. So this is the position. So under section 24, the court taking into consideration the financial capacity of the husband, whether the husband is able to pay or not, it will be taken into consideration. The other commitments of the husband, whether any claims are there, other claims, and whether the petitioner has received any relief under other act, Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act or 125 CRPC, and the basic needs and genuine needs of petitioner, and the social status and family background of the petitioner, and financial capacity, and taking into consideration all these factors, the court will decide interim relief. While deciding the interim relief or temporary relief, the court also will take into consideration whether the wife petitioner is having any aged parents of the respondent husband, or whether the minor children are there with the married woman, that is the petitioner, and the children education, if unmarried daughter is there, unmarried daughter's marriage, depending upon the social status of the marital parties, wedded couple, and depending upon the social status and paying capacity, financial capacity of the husband, all these factors will be taken into consideration for the purpose of maintenance of children education, daughter's marriage, aged parents, and other natural heirs obligations, if any. Separate application can be filed under section 26 by petitioner, that is wife. If even though the petition is not filed under section 26 of the Hindu Marriage Act, the courts are having discretionary power. Lower courts are having discretionary power under section 148 to 153B of Civil Procedure Code. Exercising their discretionary power, the civil courts can grant maintenance to the other dependents also. And another thing is, according to section 28, when once the court has sanctioned the interim relief under section 24 of the Hindu Marriage Act, this will be taken into consideration of various factors. financial position of husband and other benefits if any received by petitioner from other act, Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act or 125 CRPC. When once the interim relief is fixed by the court, the respondent cannot prefer appeal before any court according to section 28 of the Hindu Marriage Act. It cannot be, it is not appealable. The interim relief should be decided within 60 days from the date of filing the application. That is another thing. The interim relief or pendant delight fixed by court is not appealable, but the respondent can approach the high court or higher court for civil revision. Civil revision petition can be filed. It is too much, that pendant delight is too much, I cannot afford for the revision, for the purpose of revision. The respondent go, if the amount fixed is very low, the petitioner also can prefer appeal before the higher court. If it is not, the petition under section 24 must be disposed of within 60 days from the date of filing, and the order can be issued. Then from what date the order can be given will be decided by the court, from the date of filing petition or application, or from the date of issuing summons, or from the date of order will be decided by the court, taking into consideration circumstances of the case. And finally, section 28 clause A makes provision for enforcement. If the amount is not paid, the enforcement proceedings as per the procedure laid down under CPC will be taken, and the husband's properties may be seized, or the husband's salary may be confined, or husband may be put in civil prison. All these rules will be as per civil procedure code. So this is the position with reference to section 24 pendant delight, because it may take lot of time for final disposal of the case. There may be other cases for restitution of conjugal rights under section 9, or judicial separation under section 10, nullity or annulment under section 11 or 12 may be pending, and 13 divorce petition may be pending. Till it is clear, until and unless it is clear, this case cannot be settled. That is why temporary relief is provided, that is the pendant delight. Then the petitioner, wife or husband, can file petition for permanent relief. The court will sanction permanent relief under section 25 of the Hindu Marriage Act, taking into consideration the factors stated above: financial capacity of the respondent, that is husband, his other financial commitments, and a previous decree, if any, from which the petition is getting benefit, and other dependents, the children to be for education of children, marriage of unmarried daughter, and social status of the married wedded couple, social status of the basic and genuine needs, and all these factors will be taken into consideration, including the previous decree, NME, and other commitments, assets, liabilities. All the factors will be taken into consideration, and determined by the court under section 25. While fixing the final order of maintenance may be granted to the petitioner in lump sum. It may be in lakhs or crores, depending upon the social and financial status of the wedded couple, number one. And it may be paid in monthly, or it may be paid quarterly, half yearly, annually, whatever the case may be, or it may be paid in lump sum. In lump sum, there are some cases the respondent paid in crores. In depending upon the case, if the respondent they are from very rich and wealthy family, the maintenance may be lump sum amount of hundreds of crores and millions of crores or billions of crores, so that may be there. So this is, it may be monthly maintenance. This section 25 and 24 and 25 Hindu Marriage Act is over. And the next topic for discussion is section 18 clause 2 and 18 clause 1 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act 1956. Under Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act 1956, this act deals with two concepts. One is maintenance of a married woman and the other is adoption. If issueless wife or husband can take a boy or girl in adoption. That is another topic I will take up later. So here, according to section 18.2 and section 18.1 of the Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act, a married woman can claim maintenance against the husband. Under these provisions, wife alone can claim maintenance from the husband. Only Hindu Marriage Act, only husband is having a provision to claim maintenance from the wife, provided he is physically and mentally unfit, unable to make the earnings of his own for livelihood. So for Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act 18.2 means if a married woman living separately on reasonable grounds from the husband can claim maintenance. According to section 18.1, a married woman living in the same roof along with the husband can claim maintenance. So there are certain cases in which husband and wife live in the same roof. They do not talk each other. They do not care each other. In such cases, husband neglects the wife. In such cases, wife can file petition and against husband by living in the same roof. So this is the position. Next thing is, so for this also rules are generally common. The both are wife and husband must be Hindus. They are legally wedded couple as per section 5 of the Hindu Marriage Act. Here, wife can claim maintenance, unable to live on her own, not necessary. If the wife is having enough property, she is having enough earnings. A propertied woman, a woman who is having earnings also can claim maintenance against the husband. She is living separately on reasonable ground, because the grounds of divorce, section 13, desertion, cruelty, physical or mental, infectious disease and other. So if any due to some reason or other, on reasonable ground only, she is living separately. So she should not be unchaste, she should not be living in adultery, she should not get remarried, she should not take divorce under section 13b of the Hindu Marriage Act, that is divorce by mutual consent. Under this, these are the grounds under which a wife, Hindu wife or Hindu married woman can claim maintenance against the husband. So while fixing the day maintenance, the court will take into consideration the other dependents of the petitioner, that is parents of the respondent, children of the petitioner and respondent, legitimate and illegitimate, and other if widow woman legal hits, all these aspects also will be taken into consideration. So according to section 18 clause 2, a married woman who is able to live on her own, who is having property, who is having even earnings, can also claim maintenance against husband. While fixing the maintenance, the court will take into consideration financial capacity of the husband, and that is respondent, his other financial commitments, his liabilities, his assets and other dependent, and previous decree if any. All these things also will be taken into consideration. Whether in Hindu Marriage Act or in this act also there is no specific provision for temporary relief. The courts are having discretionary power to give temporary relief for pendent light in under section 18 clause 1 or 18 clause 2. 18 clause 2 refers to married woman living separately on reasonable grounds. Section 18 clause 1 refers to married woman living in the same roof. Though having sufficient earnings of livelihood, she can claim maintenance. So the maintenance also includes other dependents like children, their education, their either maintenance, aged parents if any, other dependents if any, also will be taken into consideration. Though there is no specific provision for temporary relief or pendant delight. The court is having discretionary power under inherent powers, can give temporary relief or interim relief. This is with reference to maintenance of wife under section 18 clause 1 and clause 2 of the Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act. Now next last one is section 125 CRPC. Section 125 CRPC is a special provision. It is designed to give a speedy relief to the people of all communities, Hindus, Muslims, Christians and all communities. 125 CRPC is a criminal procedure code, 1973 is a territorial law. It is applicable to the people of whole India, English, Hindus, Muslims, Christians and all. And 125 CRPC is a special and speedy provision. Section 125 to 128 of criminal procedure code make provision for maintenance of wife, children and aged parents. And under this 125 CRPC, wife can file petition independently against husband, children can file petition independently against husband, children can file petition against independently against father, and aged parents can file petition against their son. So not only son but also daughter is equally liable, married or unmarried. How a son is liable to pay maintenance to parents, daughter also he is having equal liability and obligation to claim maintenance. So in order to feed the parents, a woman can quit the matrimonial society of husband and go separately in order to pay parents, then it can be a reasonable ground. Thereafter, she can claim maintenance from husband. So here, 125 CRPC, section 125 speaks about order of magistrate, first class magistrate order fixing the maintenance. Section 126 provides procedure for filing the petition. Section 127 provides for alteration of petition. Whether the petition, whether it is the temporary relief or permanent relief, it is subject to revision, not only in Hindu Marriage Act, but also in Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act, and also 125 CRPC. The petition once, maintenance fixed once in lump sum or periodically is not constant. It is subject to revision on application, separate application by the a petitioner from time to time. Sometimes the amount of petition will be reduced, sometimes the amount of petition, amount of maintenance will be increased. For children education, there is a need for children education, or unmarried daughters married, the amount of maintenance will be increased, and it will be increased or decreased. So if there is a mutual agreement between the parties to get the amount in lump sum, so the lump sum amount will be paid at the time of a decree or order under CRPC. So this is the position. So 125 speaks about order, 126 procedure for filing the petition, 127 alteration, provision for altering the amount of maintenance from time to time, and 128 enforcement procedure. If even after order the husband in case of wife, father in case of children, and son in case of parents petition did not comply with the order of the court, then enforcement proceedings will be taken against the respondent by seizing his property, by confining his salary, or confining him civil prison and all. So now let us now discuss about wife. When wife can file a petition against husband? A married woman, who is unable to live on her own can file a petition against the husband, number one. So the marriage is a legally valid marriage. Secondly, secondly, both husband and wife are legally wedded as per their respective religion. If they are Hindus, both must be Hindus. Mohammedans, both must be Mohammedan. Christian, both must be Christians. That is the same religion. Next, living separately on reasonable ground. Living separately on reasonable ground. There are several grounds under Section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act. Desertion, cruelty, physical or mental, infectious disease, unchastity, living in adultery, or so many. Not these grounds. So living separately on reasonable grounds. Living separately on reasonable grounds. Wife is living separately because husband is suffering from, husbanding is doing cruelty. Wife is living separately because reasonable ground. Husband is employing cruelty. And husband is suffering from infectious disease. Husband is maintaining concubine. All these some reasons are there under Section 30. So, number one, belong to both couple belong to same community. Number Hindu, Muslim, Christian or whatsoever may be. Number two, the petitioner is unable to live on her own. Next, living separately on reasonable ground. Living separately on reasonable ground. After living separately, not remarried, and separated under divorce by mutual consent, Section 13B in Hindu Marriage Act and relevant provision in other religions. So, divorce by mutual consent party is not entitled to claim maintenance. So, in maintenance, the court will take into consideration. Here, there Hindu Marriage Act, Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act, District Court or Family Law Court will take cognizance of the petition. But here, 125 CRPC, the competent court is First Class Magistrate Court. The previously, the maintenance amount was 500 rupees. Subsequently, it was deleted in 2006. And today, it is not the, there is no any specific amount fixed. It will be decided, the amount or quantum of maintenance will be given depending upon the financial capacity of the respondent, depending upon the natural genuine needs of petitioner and dependent, and depending upon the social status, financial status, all these things, taking into consideration all these factors. The maintenance amount may be paid in a lump sum. It may be thousands or lakhs or crores, depending upon this. If it is a periodical, monthly or once in 3 months, once in 6 months, once in a year, like that also it can be caved. According to Section 127 CRPC, the amount, the maintenance amount sanctioned can be revised from time to time. It may be increased or it may be reduced or it may be cancelled, depending upon the circumstances of the case, by filing subsequent petition or application, subsequent petition or application by the petitioner or respondent, as the case may be. So, a married woman who is living separately on reasonable grounds, the marriage is valid as per the religion, both belong to same religion, and not remarried, not living in adultery, not unchaste, not converted into other religion, is entitled to claim. So, depending upon the financial capacity and other commitment, previous decree or order, if any, and all these factors, the taking into consideration other dependent, this amount will be fixed. Sometimes the court has discretionary power to give temporary relief. If there any cases are pending for restitution of conjugal rights, divorce, judicial separation, etc., as per their respective religion. So, temporary relief, and the court is having the power to give temporary relief, or permanent relief will be given at a time. The maintenance may be fixed in lump sum or periodically, monthly, quarterly, half yearly, annually, as the case may be, as per the convenience of the parties. So, the married woman. So, children. What kind of children are entitled to claim maintenance? All children, legitimate and illegitimate children, are entitled to claim maintenance from the father. The children, all minor children, boy or girl, and all unmarried girls of any age
All minor children, legitimate and illegitimate, can file a petition against father for maintenance under section 125 CRPC. Number two, all minor boys, all unmarried girls of any age, all children of any age, boy or girl of any age, if that boy or girl is physically or mentally disabled. All children, minor children, boy or girl below 18 years or 21 years up to guardian, in case guardian is appointed. Minor children, boys or girls, everybody. Legitimate or illegitimate. Next, all unmarried girl of any age, even 30-year-old unmarried girl can do. Physically and mentally handicapped boy or girl, even of 30-year-old, 40-year-old, 50-year-old, as the case, there is no any age limit for unmarried girl, no age limit for boy or girl who is physically or mentally disabled. Only physically, mentally able, boy only, if he is a minor, he can claim maintenance. So these are the person. They are unable to live on their own, they are common. So then if the petition is entertained by court and the court will decide, depending upon the circumstances of the case, will sanction maintenance. Next one is parents. All parents, who are unable to live on their own can claim maintenance against the son, subject to condition whether there are the other son or other daughters, if any, they also will be taken into consideration while awarding the petition. If the petitioner parent, either one parent or both parents, do not have any other son or any other daughter, this man alone, the respondent alone, will have to give maintenance. Suppose the aged parents do not have any sons, only one daughter. If other daughter or son are there, they are financially incompetent, they are not able to have their own bread, they are unable to, but only one son or daughter is there. So even daughter also, married or unmarried, is under obligation to give maintenance to the parent. Suppose there is a married woman living with husband, she has parents, she is the only daughter, no other brother or sister, the parents are starving at a old age, the wife requests the husband, my parents are starving, may I bring my parents to home? Then husband refuses, so I find it difficult to feed you, how can I feed your parents, he says. Then she said, no sir, no, when my parents are starving, I cannot take food at home, so I want to go out and feed my parents by doing some job. And she can quit matrimonial society of husband, that is also will become reasonable ground, she can claim maintenance from the husband. So this is the case. So the Supreme Court made it clear, even daughter, married or unmarried, can claim maintenance from the daughter. So this is the position under section 25. So now we said that section 125 CRPC is a common provision, special provision, speedy provision. It gives quickest, fastest relief to the petitioner. This is applicable to not only Hindus but also Christians and Mohammedans also. That is why this 125 CRPC was applied to Hindu women. There is a leading case, Shabanu versus Mohammed Ahmad Khan. So the Shabanu Mohammed Khan, a lawyer, a renowned lawyer, got married after a long time, after giving birth to 5 children, that is 2 sons and 3 daughters, I think. He got married at the age of above 60 years. Ahmad Khan got married, second marriage. Subsequently, he neglected the first wife, Shabanu. Shabanu filed petition in District Court, Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh District Court gave decree, ordered Ahmad Khan to give maintenance to Shabanu. But Ahmad Khan, being lawyer, challenged that it is against to the norms of their Muslim religion. A Muslim woman is not entitled to get maintenance beyond iddat period. He challenged it before Madhya Pradesh High Court. Madhya Pradesh High Court also confirmed the judgment of the lower court, that the judicial court. According to Madhya Pradesh High Court also, the Ahmad Khan was asked to give maintenance to Shah Bano. Then he preferred appeal before Supreme Court and challenged it. The Supreme Court also said, confirmed the judgment of the High Court. So, not only District Court, High Court and Supreme Court gave direction to Ahmad Khan to pay maintenance to Shah Bano, because 125 CRPC is a common provision applicable to Hindus, Muslims, Christians and all. As such, you are directed to give maintenance to Shah Bano. This gave a lot of discussion. This decision of the Supreme Court gave uproar among Muslim heads that. So this is the judgment of the Supreme Court is in violation of Muslim law, rights and norms. So according to Muslim law, a male Mohammedan is not under obligation to pay maintenance to wife beyond iddat period. It is against to our Quran and our Muslim laws. They have challenged. So lot of discussion took place all over India. One Mohammedan minister tried his level best to overrule the Supreme Court decision, but he failed and he was constrained to give resignation. Subsequently, lot of acts agitation took place in order to satisfy the Muslim heads. Then government passed an act. That act is Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 1985 was passed. According to this act, Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 1985, this 125 CRPC was made optional to Hindu male. Suppose when Hindu Muslim woman files petition against husband under section 125 CRPC, if the court grants maintenance, if Muslim husband is a good man, he can give maintenance. If he doesn't like to give, she has no ground. She had to depend upon parents or brothers and other revere or dear. So after this passing of this act 1985, Supreme Court decision is not mandatory, and it became optional to Muslim male. If Muslim male is good man, he gave maintenance. He otherwise no. So Shah Bano was given divorce by professing talak, triple talak. Subsequently, there had been an agitation about abolition of triple talak. Many countries, 23 countries abolished triple talak, Muslim countries abolished talak. In India, in our surrounding countries, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh also abolished triple talak. There is a consistent and unstinted demand for abolition of triple talak in India, but the Muslim heads are preventing, the governments are in helpless. But recently, the government of India, headed by Narendra Modi ji, took it very serious to abolish triple talak and denial profession of talak was punishable under section Indian Penal Code. And subsequently, this case was filed by Shaira Banu versus Union of India. In that case, the Supreme Court five member bench decided the case. The five member bench, a 2017 case, five judges belong to five religion. One is one judge belongs to Hindu, one judge belongs to Muslim, one judge belongs to Christianity, one judge belongs to Sikh and other. Five judges belong to five religion. They decided the case by 3:2 majority. 3:2, three judges decided in favor of abolition. Two judges opined against abolition. Ultimately, by majority of 3:2, three judges decided the case in favor of abolition, and thereby they recommended abolition of triple talak, and they recommended to the central government to pass law within 6 months. In pursuance of Supreme Court verdict, the government of India, headed by Narendra Modi ji, issued ordinance ordinance, abolition of triple talaq ordinance, and subsequently a bill was presented in Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, once because of there was objection from opposite parties to refer it to steering committee, selection committee, and then once it was postponed. Second time also, due to Lok Sabha elections, it was postponed. Third time, the government of India made very quick steps for approval of the bill, and before its lapse in sometime in 2020, he got it approved by the President of India after the presidential assent. This triple talaq bill passed into law in August, sometime in July 2020. From 1st August 2020, triple talaq was made an offence. If anybody, any Muslim male profess triple talaq to give divorce to the wife, he is punishable under Indian Penal Code, and he is punishable under the Muslim Woman Protection of Divorce, Muslim Woman Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 2019 Act. Earlier 2085 Act, that same title, that is 1985, according to that, the maintenance is optional. Muslim male could give or could not give. Talaq or triple talaq was there. But 2019 Muslim Woman Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 2019, triple talaq was made punishable under punishable with 3 years imprisonment. There is no more triple talaq. Triple talaq is abolished. At the same time, the Muslim male 125 CRPC is equally applicable to Muslim law, and the Muslim male must honor the direction or order of the court and must pay maintenance to the Muslim one. This is the position with reference to 125 CRPC, dear friend. Dear friend, in this lecture I gave sometime in previously, this judgment is in a this is an improvement over the previous lecture, and I am trying my level best to cover all the topic. So many students are asking so many subjects. Dear friend, please kindly understand my position. So accepting almost all the subjects is not a joke. It's very hard labor. So writing books is easy. We can see so many books and write. But teaching subject means we have to teach without seeing anything. If I see something and dictate something, I won't be able to cover maximum volume. If I, without seeing anything, by speaking directly, quickly only, I'll be able to cover maximum volume in one class. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. Please offer your comments so that I can take the next topic. Thank you very much. So in recently, I gave lectures to students of Telugu. Some 4 lectures, and all the 3 lectures I have uploaded here. Nullity, section 9, restitution of conjugal right, 10 and 11, nullity and alignment and maintenance. The importance of marriage, I gave very good lecture in previously. It has nearly 17,000 views, 16,000 views long back. So that same as it is, there is no any change. That is why the first lecture, importance of marriage, sacrament, sacrosanct. I need not translate, give a lecture once again. There is no any developments. Thank you. Next lecture, I will take up jurisprudence. Jurisprudence, best topic I will take. Thank you, dear friend. So I am very unhappy that I am not able to speak Hindi fluently. That is why I am not able to give lecture in Hindi. And it's a great loss for me, because it would be very good if I would be able to give lecture at the request of my student friends in Telugu, Telugu states. I started delivering lectures in Telugu also recently. I delivered 4 lectures on family law. And gradually I am giving lectures, but Hindi also I am interested, but I do not have that much language comment. Please understand. We see. So, if I don't have Hindi language, what is the great loss for me? So, I won't be able to do my better service to students of Hindi. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.